It's an unreal feeling to get lifted up by four leaf blowers.
Now keep in mind, this is a prototype, so there is some duct tape involved here. But lots of duct tape is just a sign of a great engineering prototype.
When my wife and I first moved to California, I was dying to learn how to skimboard. I saw someone on the beach doing it, and it just looked effortless and so much fun. It turns out that it's actually very hard and very painful. So, of course, my thoughts while doing this for 2 hours and only getting to skim for 30 seconds is, what if I didn't have to stick to this tiny little strip of shallow water? What if we could skim anywhere?
The skimboard works by allowing the rider to glide along on a thin film of water that eliminates the friction between the board and the sand. My goal is to eliminate the need for that thin film of water and instead use a cushion of air between the board and the ground so we can skim anywhere. Here's a front cross-section view with a little better explanation. Now, you might be thinking, Brendan, you're not Marty McFly, and hoverboards don't actually exist, at least not yet. Well, no, true hoverboards don't exist yet. And just using the airflow from some fans to fly around with, well, that would take a lot of energy. Instead, by capturing some of that airflow in an inflated skirt, we end up with a large volume of high-pressure air underneath the board. You don't need a lot of pressure because the surface area is so big that just a few PSI can lift the rider. The purpose of the inflated skirt is to conform to the uneven ground underneath the hovercraft. This keeps a high-pressure pocket of air underneath the board and allows just enough to escape to have a thin layer of air for the entire craft to glide along. So on the top deck of the board, we've got four of what are apparently the most powerful electric leaf blowers you can buy, at least the most powerful handheld ones. So I'm gonna make a hole in the deck right here, and all the air is gonna come out through a duct down into the deck to lift me up. I think the 4 feet is a good width, but I'm gonna shorten it a little bit because the length of 8 feet makes it a bit unwieldy. I basically just need enough length so that when I attach these to the deck, I still have room to get the batteries off. So I'm gonna put these as close as possible, mark the outline on the deck, and then we'll get to cutting. I picked up a hot wire cutter for this job, so I don't have to make tons of tiny little plastic foam bits. Yeah, it is one of the most satisfying tools I've ever owned. I'm gonna use the wood I just cut out as a template to cut out the foam that I'm gonna sandwich between the two sides of the board. Final step today, to sandwich the foam between the two pieces of wood, glue it, and clamp it. That's gonna give us a super strong base to stand on. Okay, our glue has been drying now for 24 hours. It's time to take all this weight off of here, move on to our next steps. Oh! It's actually like really light and stiff. I think it's gonna hover. Feel like I might regret this, but time for a strength test. I mean, you gotta do it. Oh my God. That's actually incredible. None of these materials would hold me on their own, not even close. But when you layer them like this, that is pretty cool. Let's proceed. Okay, here's the plan. Four holes in the board with a 5-inch hole saw, which fits perfectly a 4-inch ABS elbow to direct the airflow from the leaf blower downwards through the board. Let's go.
Bubby's a little one-eyed stray that wandered into my garage 3 weeks ago now. He's still getting used to our antics here, but might be a little confused by the hoverboard building though. What do you think? Is this the weirdest place you've ever lived?
Duct tape on these, close up any air gaps. We're ready to move on to the next step, which would be building the skirt. Okay, the skirt is done. It is time for the hover test. I feel like my television career depends upon this moment, and I'm so nervous. Hearing protection required.
It works. I can't believe it. It's an unreal feeling to get lifted up by four leaf blowers. Time to make a couple improvements, and we're good to go.
Now it's time for our first outdoor test with help from my friend, Michelle. But first, I just had a couple of adjustments to make to the build before starting.
So initial testing in the garage didn't have quite enough airflow coming out from under the skirt. So I've drilled a ton of holes, which Michelle says looks like a woodpecker got to our hovercraft, and she's not wrong. And I'm also gonna add some more slits out of the skirt. We got way too much pressure in the skirt, and we need a lot more airflow coming out from underneath the hovercraft, hover skimboard, technically. Then we're gonna have our first little trial run here on the grass.
To reduce that excess pressure in the skirt, I cut a bunch of rectangular holes throughout. The duct tape is there to prevent the cuts from spreading further into the tarp. Remember that airflow coming out from underneath the board is very important to keep us hovering. The primary function of the skirt is to conform to the ground and keep it relatively sealed. With the modifications complete, it was time to get hovering.
So one of the problems I found in the garage is that I have two hands and there's four leaf blowers, which means I can only turn on two leaf blowers at a time. And when I get the first two turned on, the air starts to blow backwards out of the other two, and there's some sort of safety on them that won't let them turn on. You do need a friend to start up the hovercraft because you do have to turn all four leaf blowers on at the same time.
3, 2, 1.
Wow, that's dusty. That was like ridiculously successful.
So we need to secure the leaf blowers better. And we need to seal up the ducts a little bit because we have a lot of like backflow from the air. And I think we actually need a little bit more ventilation underneath still, because if you notice like the shuttering of the skirt, we had a little bit of cavitation because there's a bit too much pressure in the skirt still.
Okay, a quick aside about cavitation. In each of the leaf blowers is a propeller, and air normally flows smoothly over the blades of that propeller in laminar flow. But when the pressure ahead of that propeller gets too high, this propeller can't push the air forward anymore. And so our laminar flow disintegrates. We get turbulence and waves of pressure throughout the system.
Still not quite enough air escaping out from underneath, although there's enough to support me and slide along, but I think I'd actually cruise a little bit better if I have a little bit more airflow coming out from underneath. It's crazy because, well, I guess it's not really touching the ground. I thought that the tarp would kind of be wearing, like scraping on the pavement. So yeah, it's shiny. It doesn't even look like it's touched the ground. I guess going down the driveway, it doesn't really touch the ground. It's just air touching the ground, which is pretty cool.
Gotta make a couple more adjustments, and then we're off to the beach.
Get in, let's go hoverboarding.
Okay, first trial at the beach. Now keep in mind, this is a prototype, so there is some duct tape involved here.
But lots of duct tape is just a sign of a great engineering prototype.
So we got the elbows duct tape to the board, and the leaf blowers duct tape to the elbows, and the leaf blowers duct tape to the board. During the first startup, I had issues with the leaf blowers just kind of blowing out. Hopefully that'll hold everything together.
This will likely end in failure, but we're gonna put that off for as long as possible.
If nothing else, the hover skimboard is at least quite the conversation starter. What amazed me right off the bat is how easily it moved across the rough sand, the soft sand with all the footprints in it, which I really thought would mess it up. Skimming across the packed wet sand was an absolute delight. It felt like a tiny bit of momentum would keep me going a really long way. The challenge here was the sheer weight of the board. If the board was at a standstill when I hopped on, only a very small amount of my inertia would be turned into forward movement. The slight slope of the beach would send me right towards the waves. We picked up a few spectators along the way who wanted to get some cell phone clips to show their kids. They also asked me where they could buy one.
I'm still just as tired, but I'm having more fun.
So it glides exceptionally well over the sand. And at this point, I am so tempted to just take off down this slope and go straight out over the water. But I don't want to put four leaf blowers in the ocean because I know if I don't time it right, that shore break is going to swamp me immediately. Then I'm just going to be making a bunch of garbage. So I think the skimboard wins there.
On land, though, the hover skimboard is still the clear winner. With our beach test over, we took the hover skimboard back to the farm for one last hurrah. This time, a no-holds-barred, high-speed, downhill skim to push our new invention to its limits. It was at this point I discovered, by shifting my weight, I could steer the board, putting more pressure on one side and creating friction, and forcing air out from under the skirt in the opposite direction. I could turn and follow the road and sort of go where I wanted to go. The board started to show some signs of stress, but I wanted to see if I could make a hover bike real quick.
Got a bit of a tear, a bit of a hole. It's wearing through a little bit.
Himself all the crafts in the world, but he'll still end up on a bike.
Oh, thanks, my favorite.
Now, we've got quite a size difference here. So in considering success versus failure, this is a minimalist, cheap, easy to carry around piece of equipment. And this is exactly the opposite. It's complicated, it's kind of expensive, and it's really heavy. Now, why the large size? Well, our lifting force is generated in pounds per square inch. So when you have a lot of pounds, you also need a lot of square inches. Generating additional pressure isn't really an option because you're always gonna have lots of airflow escaping, and that's a part of the design of a hovercraft. Not only that, it's far more at home on a dirt road going down a hill than it is on the beach, but who wants to go to the beach anyway? I mean, sunscreen and sand and surfers and nah. Did I succeed at making a viable alternative to the skimboard? Probably not. But did we make something really fun? Was it a good, satisfying DIY project? Absolutely.